The aim of my first lecture is to propose a conjectural Riemann-Hilbert correspondence for a deformation quantization, a certain class of deformation quantization of algebraic symplectic manifolds, and related to the Floyer theory of holomorphic Lagrangian submanifolds. So it will be related and in a sense generalize what Maxim was talking about yesterday. So let me recall that in his talk he considered something which we called irregular curve, but irregular curve, it in fact a smooth curve with finitely many what he called singular terms, kind of Laurent polynomials in local coordinates, assigned, well, with multiplicities. Well, assigned to a finite set of points. Finite set of points. So that's a geometric illustration of the data. We have finitely many points. At each point, we have a collection parameterized by the index alpha of, let's call them Laurent polynomials for negative Laurent polynomials for simplicity. All right. Now, with this, one can associate a holomorphic symplectic manifold, a cotangent bundle, and also by sequence of blow-ups explained yesterday in his lecture, we can extend it to a bigger manifold, which is in fact Poisson, which encodes, which depends on these singular terms. So he called them singular terms. So the process was roughly by first by compactifying fiberwise a cotangent bundle, which means adding a copy of X at infinity, and then making a sequence of blow-ups and picking up only those divisors at which the pullback of the holomorphic symplectic form, canonical symplectic form here, pullback to the blow-up space has a pulse of degree one. So this explains this log. It's sort of a log extension. I will give a general definition later on. Now, then the Riemann-Hilbert correspondence for these irregular curves, roughly speaking, he gave a precise formulation yesterday. It relates a category of holonomic DX modules with a prescribed collection of singular terms, or just to say it short, the category of holonomic D modules on this regular curve with a certain category of constructible shifts. and X. So these were the constructible sheaves with singular support containing the union of positive conormal bundles to a collection of real analytic curves on X, which were explicitly defined in terms of these singular terms. And he also mentioned, although did not elaborate, that this category is equivalent to a certain Foucault type category. Let me simply call Foucault category, which is, roughly speaking, the category, a subcategory in the Foucault category of the cotangent bundle of T star of X, generated by the collection of non-compact Lagrangian submanifolds, which are exactly those positive conormal bundles. If you remember, he had a collection of real analytic curves, and then he considered certain cylinders, like positive conormal bundles, which are non-compact Lagrangian subvarieties in the in this M, where the symplectic form was a real part of this holomorphic omega 2,0. All right. So this result, in fact, so this what he explained, it's just a reformulation of Deligne-Malgrange irregular correspondence, a little bit updated when we want to include not only irregular connections, but also delta functions in the story. And this second equivalence, it's basically another reformulation which can be derived from the work of several people, most notably Nadler, Schender, Zaslow, and others. No, it's a growing group of people, which basically says that if we are dealing with a cotangent bundle, then various Foucault categories can be reformulated in terms of constructible sheaves. Now, we can a little bit modify this framework. In particular, we can rescale the symplectic form by a complex parameter which is suggestively denoted by h bar. It's a Planck constant. Then instead of demodules which we have in the case h equal 1, we have a family. So we can talk about h demodules. Are kind of expressions of this sort, where H is tied up to dx. And this is an example of a deformation quantization. This algebra considered, there are different versions which I will discuss later. We can think of it as algebra over Laurent polynomials, over, if we can extend it to Taylor series, we can work over germs of analytic functions. I will need all these versions later on. But anyway, roughly it's a deformation quantization of this symplectic manifold, holomorphic symplectic manifold. So if you look at this Riemann-Hilbert correspondence, that's a general feature. We have something which can be roughly called the Ram side, which is local in nature, because some sheaves, it's local in X. And the other one, so let me forget about this. This is just an accident, and as I will explain, this is a more fundamental object. And here I will talk about the Betti site. Sort of terminology influenced by non-abelian Hodge theory. But anyway, it's clear what do I mean. This is kind of analytic story, and this is essentially it's topological. Now, after rescaling the symplectic form, we can consider, so on the left-hand side, we will have something on the Durham side, something like a deformation quantization. And on the Betti side, we have not just an individual category, Foucault category, but a family. So on the Betti side of Riemann-Hilbert, we'll have family parameterized by complex parameter. So first in C star, family of Foucault categories. And differently from the Durham site, where looks very much similar for all H's which are not equal to zero, on the Betti side, we can have some new phenomena. In particular, this family can have a monodromy. Can have monodromy. This is an H-plane. So this is parameter H. This is one feature, and also for countably many directions or values, if you like, the argument of H in general countably many. We can have a Stokes phenomenon. So also Stokes rays. This family can be modified. We can and we will modify these Foucault categories by certain equivalences. And this is where this Fleur theory will play a role. All right. Depending on what, if you like, ground field for the deformation or ground ring for the deformation quantization I will consider. So I will talk either about the formal deformation quantization, which is kind of a more well-known topic, or about analytic, or even about algebraic. But in general, whatever Riemann-Hilbert correspondence I will get, so I will talk say about formal or analytic Riemann-Hilbert correspondence, I will need to impose some additional data in order to. Formulate them. Now, here is the plan of the lecture. So first I will discuss in general. So I will work in not necessarily in one-dimensional case. It will serve just for as an illustration. But in general, the Riemann-Hilbert correspondence, as I told you, it's conjectural. So first I start with what I call this log extensions of algebraic symplectic manifolds and quantizable compactifications. Mm. a sort of a quasi-classical geometry which has to be quantized. Now I will talk about semi-formal analytic and algebraic deformation quantization. And the corresponding holonomic DQ modules, deformation quantization modules. I understand that Pierre will give a talk on that later today. So unfortunately, there is kind of the talks are given in the wrong order. But roughly speaking, in this example, it's just category of modules or this algebra of H differential operators such that modulo H, they have Lagrangian support. So it's a very simple notion. Then I will discuss local Foucault categories. As a family or a punctured complex line with a coordinate h bar and at this point I will be able to formulate Riemann-Hilbert correspondence over formal power series. It's a formal Riemann-Hilbert correspondence. So next, I will impose some convergence assumption. Which is Floyer type restriction in general. And after that, introduce Stokes automorphisms associated with Stokes rays. And formulate, let me call it meromorphic Riemann-Hilbert, because everywhere I will invert the Planck constant. What happened when I want to extend this family to h equal to 0? It's another interesting question, which I will not discuss today. And also, at this point, I should say that there will be two type of convergence assumptions, local, which depends on the particular Lagrangian submanifold, and the global. And therefore, there will be two versions of meromorphic Riemann-Hilbert, local and global, with respect to the Lagrangian. And whatever, I don't know how much time will I have at this point, but if the time permit, I will speak about Riemann-Hilbert functor as viewed from the point of view of the Floyer theory. So that's the plan. And I start with I start with the log extensions. So extension. So first, kind of formal definition. So suppose we have a smooth algebraic. Okay, many words. It's easy to say. Kind of algebraic symplectic manifold. Mixture of terminologies over complex numbers. Let's say dimension 2n. Definition, a log extension of M, or if you like, of M with this holomorphic symplectic form is a smooth Poisson variety, which I denote M log, so over complex numbers, such that several conditions are satisfied. So the complement is a simple normal crossing divisor, fine union. So you can keep in mind this yesterday Maxim examples. So this will be these blown up divisors, exceptional divisors, which appeared in his talk. And M is a cotangent bundle to the curve. Second, there exists local analytic coordinates . Let me just denote this D log, this log divisor so near D log, which means near such that well, and also I will need a number k. Now, such that this divisor is simply part of the whole story. It's product from 1 to this k of xi. And most importantly, this explains the term that the holomorphic or algebraic, in fact, it's algebraic by assumption, but now we treat it as a holomorphic symplectic form, can be written as a sum of two pieces. The second one is irregular, and here we have just the rest of the coordinates, which do not appear here, but oh, sorry, up to k. Thank you. Yeah, up to k. Okay. Now, so it follows that if we look for the inverse for the Poisson bracket, then it vanishes. And this D log looks with order 1. Okay. Now, there are two classes of examples. One is a cotangent bundle, but let's, for simplicity, indeed, just consider this yesterday example from Maxim Stock. Which I explained, I recall you previously. And the second class of examples are symplectic tori with a constant symplectic form And then every toric compactification gives some example of the log extension. So this defines by choice of a rational fan. So then there are plenty of these. And so the cotangent bundles, of course, will lead us to HD modules in general. And here we have a different theory of after quantization. So I'm a little bit ahead. We have something. So here we have HD modules in the quantized, well, in the world of quantized objects. Here we have difference equations, something like FQX, where Q is a parameter. And it's an interesting question, which I think Maxim will discuss in his second talk. And I will discuss, again, a higher dimensional conjecture, which we propose. And so it will be in the next week in the conference. There are some interesting examples. For example, like Delpeza surfaces with removed nodal projective lines, or like P2, like projective plane without elliptic curve. It will lead even to more interesting examples of algebras after quantization. For Delpeza, I think it will be something related to rational Cherednik algebras. And for P2 minus elliptic curves, it will be Odesky-Fagan elliptic algebra. So we can have very different non-commutative objects after quantization. Okay, now we propose a general conjecture still in the classical world. So the general conjecture, it shouldn't be probably called a conjecture, it's rather an expectation. That there exists a class of algebraic symplectic manifolds which includes cotangent bundles and symplectic and complex symplectic tori, satisfying the following properties. Rather property. So for any algebraic Lagrangian subvariety, so when I say subvariety, so it can be singular. So L, let's call M, subvariety L. There exists a log extension M log, which depends on L, such that the closure of L in this log extension is compact. M log is not compact. Yeah. So we expect that, I mean, the meaning of these log extensions is that we expect that with any log extension, one can associate a reasonable class of holonomic DQ modules whose supports are these nice Lagrangian subvarieties. So nice means that the closure of their support is compact in the chosen M log. And also this restriction, if you'd like. So that's picture from Maxim Stock. So we have some non-compact L. It's non-compact in the Katangian bundle. It's a spectral curve in one dimension. So let's call them spectral curve. And these are these additional divisors. So in what we get in this M log, the closure is compact. In fact, it intersects in his example each divisor, but at most finitely many points. No. It's all classical. What I'm saying is that the meaning is that if we choose some M log. No, I do not ask. No, it's not even clear that this is true quasi-classically.
Yeah,
but we expect, you know, everything today is conjectural. So then. Yeah, that's exactly, we know this for these two things, and then. In some other examples, as I mentioned, for this Cherednik algebras and elliptic algebras, it's also known, but it's kind of, you know, like there are different levels. There is this rational, trigonometric, elliptic, so then there are examples, but as for classes, yes, we know this for curves and for tori. Then we can quantize any of them. Okay, now, and also I will need this property for on the Betti side for the Fukaya categories, because I need to have a control on my non-compact Lagrangians, how they will go, how they behave at infinity. All right. And now I will discuss the first at Derham side of Riemann-Hilbert. Riemann-Hilbert, it will be basically a reminder because a useful class of log extension, so a useful class of log extensions, it comes from what Maxim proposed 16 years ago. It's called quantizable compactifications. So comes from quantizable compactifications. Around 2000 or something like that. Okay, so I recall this terminology because I will use some of these. Actually, it doesn't have to be in the framework of symplectic. It can be any Poisson. So the M, B, and algebraic Poisson manifold. Let's work. So we work over complex numbers today. And M is a normal crossing divisor compactification. now this is indeed compact. So we say that this compactification is quantizable. If several properties are satisfied, so some of them homological nature. Now, how to say it? Poisson bivector field extends from M to M bar, extends to M bar, and it is tangent in the precise sense, which I do not want to discuss. It's tangent to the compactifying divisor. And the last condition is, okay, I don't know, maybe I need the notation. Yeah, I need this notation example. Okay, class of this divisor is ample. Class of D. Normal crossing in general for what I, for my next phrase is not necessary, but since I defined, No, I mean, for log extension, I need, and since I will, okay, so then the, no, I mean, the construction of M log is that I simply pick up those divisors, okay. So let me just say, so because you need it for one purpose, and you need it a little bit more restrictive purpose. So if M is symplectic, not just Poisson but symplectic, then this condition of vanishing condition means that it has poles at D. And so we can define M log by taking only those components where those poles are of order one. So since I defined M log as something which has simple normal crossing, so then at least here I should say. All right. Now, the meaning of this definition, it was explained in the theorem. I think I even have archive reference for that. Yeah, it can be found in the archives. Indeed, you can quantize it. Let's fix in the following sense. It's more restrictive than just a formal quantity. So suppose we have a quantizable compactification, then there exists an associative algebra. So which makes him denote like this, fine states, because it's finite. It's an algebra a priori over formal over Taylor series only, such that It satisfies several properties. So first, it's a quantization in the naive sense. So modulo H, it reproduces the algebra of regular functions with its Poisson bracket. Secondly, this algebra has an exhaustive filtration. Compatible with the product. Which admits, how to say it, admitting, it's too many, a splitting over the ground ring. OM, it's a quantization of the original M. So this M bar is used, I mean, to construct. It's kind of, you know, if you have this ampleness condition, you have a line bundle, you can associate the associated graded ring and then localize and get.
In algebra, you mean the shape or a stack of
algebra? I mean the algebra. Yeah. Associative algebra. Not necessarily, but I mean. Oh, yeah, yeah, M is a fine, yeah, otherwise it's, yeah. Yeah, it's automatic, yeah. I mean, that's, yeah, M is a fine, so I should. Yeah, yeah, it follows, but it's okay. A fine, yeah, otherwise it doesn't make sense. Okay, now one more condition. That this filtration, it's still filtration over Taylor series, but we can take it mod H, so it induces the filtration how to denote it. OM, such that the corresponding RIS ring is finitely generated. Over complex numbers, of course, because now everything is quasi-classical. All right, so as I'm telling you, I do not need a construction. I just explain this terminology, but basically the construction is, you can look in this paper, but you use the ample line bundle to construct the associated graded ring, and then you localize it. So this quantization is called, I think, yeah, he called it semi-formal. Semi-formal quantization. M, or maybe better to say, of the quantizable compactification of M. And it has more chances to be algebraic in the sense that we can replace a formal series by something convergent. But first, a few remarks about this formal, so we can define holonomic modules. Do we have annotation? No, I just call them holonomic DQ modules. So again, in the usual way, that the modules such that support is a Lagrangian subvariety, Lagrangian variety, complex Lagrangian variety. Now it gives us an abelian category. I think we need to invert H for that. That's what I'm telling you. You can, from the very beginning, you can assume that it's topologically free. So then probably, it's abelian category over Lorentz series. Now, it has a subcategory for this. I have a notation. Subcategory, it's still, everything is formal. It's a subcategory for those for which, let me call it L, for which this L is nice in the sense that L does not intersect the divisors which are not logarithmic, and the closure of L in M log is compact. Okay, and there is a version, so if we fix L, then there is a subcategory here. Which consisting of those DQ modules which have the fixed support. So is such that they have L as a support, well, mod H, so quasi classic. All right, all these are abelian categories. But I want to have a possibility to fix a Planck constant. So you can imagine that, at least in the example of HD modules and curves, we can put H equal to 1 and get usual D modules. So you can imagine that sometimes in general, we can work not only over formal series, but over something smaller. And so for that, I introduce, this will be just assumptions. So I don't know in what generality. So algebraicity and analyticity assumptions. So this simply means that, an analyticity means that this is an algebra over the ring of germs of analytic functions. And all the conditions which are on the blackboard, they hold over this smaller ring. The ring itself is, yeah. Well, okay, it is contained. Ah, yes. This is a definition. Okay, so repeat. All right, repeat the definition, but assume. Yeah, so probably I should put some, I don't know, analyticity. So yeah, it's not the same. It's different. Okay, and similarly, algebraicity. And here, these are just polynomials. All right. No, it's not, it's different. I mean, it's not the same. I mean, when they define the, if they work microlocally, they do it on the Cartesian bundle, yeah? So you have a collection of symbols and your convergence, and blah, blah, blah. But this is kind of, it's an additional variable which you use to convert them. It's later to a deformation quantization parameter. So then, okay, this is the end of the Derham story. So then I'm erasing it from the blackboard, and I will discuss the Betti side. On the Betti side, so there are more foundational questions, not of which are settled. But we'll be optimistic. So local Foucault categories. And subsequently, we'll have a formal Riemann-Hilbert correspondence. So that's what we start with. Let's see. Oh, unfortunately, I erased. So I will formulate the Riemann-Hilbert correspondence later for this category, assuming that the support of my DQ modules is fixed. Right. So then I fix the algebraic symplectic manifold. I fix the log extension. The log extension is non-unique. So let's fix one. And also, I fix the good complex Lagrangian subvariety. Good means that the closure is compact in M-log. So that's what we have. These data arise naturally from the Derham side. And so what we expect, that with this data, we associate the local system will be local used in many ways. local system of A infinity categories, which we denote as this. Each belong to C star. So each of these categories is in fact a category over integers. And so we call them local Foucault categories. So first it's a kind of announcement. So what we expect, local Foucault categories. Associated with L, local Foucault categories associated with L. And roughly speaking, it's a Foucault category of a sufficiently small neighborhood of L in M. Roughly speaking. So I recall you that normally Foucault categories, they are considered in the framework of real analytic, real symplectic manifolds. So here we can always make it M into C infinity symplectic manifold. Algebraic even. And rescaling the complex, symplectic form by the parameter, we have a family of such. We also have, so this is the real symplectic form. I should say that we also have the B field. Field, which is used in the definition of the Foucault category, but I will ignore it completely. At least in the case when L is a complex Lagrangian, the B field vanishes on L. So then let's forget about it. So it's C infinity symplectic family of such. Again, I recall you that normally in this Foucault business, the Foucault category has an objects pairs. Conventionally, these are Lagrangian submanifolds, which means they are not singular, and these are flat bundles, so local systems. L prime. The morphisms are defined between two generic Lagrangians by means of the Fourier theory. And there are also higher corrections, which are defined by counting of pseudo-holomorphic disks in the auxiliary almost complex structure with the boundary on this Lagrangian. So it's kind of an industry. What is missing is a version of this theory when L prime is not necessarily smooth. And that's exactly what we will need. But we'll assume that at the end of Simon's grant, it will be, this goal will be achieved. So we need, again, let me just recapitulate. So we need this Foucault framework which is a little bit more general than conventional. So L is singular, or L prime singular, and L prime is non-compact. So this is more difficult. Some work has been done in that direction, and this is what sometimes referred as a wrapped Foucault categories. Studied by many people by now, but started with Abu Zaid and Zeidel, followed by the initial work on symplectic homology. So then, in order to illustrate the relationship of this story to the Riemann-Hilbert, I will recall kind of an archetypical result of Abu Zaid, which explains, which this is rigorously proved, one of the several things which are rigorously proved is the wrapped Foucault category of the cotangent bundle. X is compact, it's C-infinity framework. So compact manifold. So it's a theorem that's it's W states for apt. So again, I don't have time to explain even in minimal preciseness what how to define these categories, but the answer is that whatever is called the wrapped Foucault category, it is generated by a non-compact Lagrangian submanifold, which is a cotangent bundle. So typically people just use this picture to illustrate what the wrapped Foucault category is. So this is X, this is a cotangent bundle, it's non-compact Lagrangian, and basically generated means that the whole category can be presented as an algebra of perfect modules over endomorphisms of the cotangent fiber. So there is a generator, and it's clearly it's non-compact. And this wrapped business, in order to define endomorphisms, in usual Foucault, we need to use some Hamiltonian perturbation of an object in order to define for Lagrangian, in order to define the endomorphisms. And here, the Hamiltonians allow the infinitely many intersections because of the non-compactness, in particular in this example. And so this algebra is quasi-isomorphic to the algebra of chains on the base loop space. So it's a base loops. It's a DG algebra. Based loops. So then we can consider, so then the whole thing is a DG category of perfect modules over it, but we can consider finite dimensional representations, if you'd like, of this category, consider functors to complexes to the derived category of vector spaces, or if you'd like, we can consider modules over this, which are finite dimensional. And so then this is the model for the fundamental group. Or if you'd like, for the group algebra, let's take, I don't know, complex coefficients, group algebra. And therefore, finite dimensional representations, it's just a local systems on X. Yeah, it's for K, yeah, sure. You didn't allow me to cheat, yeah. Then this is quasi-isomorphism. but it would be nicer, yeah. This is, yeah, all right. So anyway, then for K v, X, which is K pi 1, for example, for the torus, this category, the finite dimensional representations of this category, which means functors, whatever, be C vector spaces, can be, of course, any field. It's the same in the derived sense as representations of the finite dimensional representation of the fundamental group, which means that they are local systems. So which is part of the category of constructible sheaves. And therefore, in the derived sense, we can forget about local systems, work with this. And this is the same as this. And therefore, it explains why on the Betti side of the Riemann-Hilbert in general, we should expect not the constructible sheaves, but expect something like the wrapped Foucault category. Okay, so that's motivation. By the way, in the examples of the cylinders, yeah, this when X is indeed just a circle, which is a KP1, so then this endomorphisms, it's the algebra of Laurent series, which is a group algebra of the fundamental group of a circle. Yeah, so we have this coherent sheaves with finite support, which appears yesterday in Maxim's talk. Remember exactly, he interpreted it in this way. All right. So this is something about wrapped Foucault category, and the general strategy is the same. So we would like so we fix a complex Lagrangian, and we would like to define some kind of a wrapped, or to be more honest, partially wrapped Foucault category. So this is our L, support of the DQ module, which can be singular. So we take, we can choose some metric on the cotangent bundle. So this is L, and this is some epsilon neighborhood of L. It is Stein. So there are various restrictions on M, which allows us in general to define wrapped Foucault category. So there are some restrictions. Mainly, they are due to the fact that we can have this infinite wrapping, and we want to have the Fleur theory well behaved. In particular, the moduli space of pseudo-holomorphic disks should allow us to count. We want to, for example, to define the Fleur differential, so we need to have some compactness condition. But for Stein manifolds, everything is fine, so then it's kind of a good bonus from L being not just the C infinity Lagrangian, but the complex Lagrangian. And now, what's the proposed definition of the local Foucault category? It goes like this. L consists of several smooth components. They're visible here. Let's choose a point at each smooth component and consider a transversal Lagrangian disk do I have annotation? TI. Transversal Lagrangian, I call it disk. It's just a transversal Lagrangian. So if you forget about the rest, you see in the neighborhood it looks like a tangent bundle.
So I assume that your manifold is symmetric, or
it's just possible? My manifold is complex. So I think I mentioned what I fixed. All this is fixed. Okay, fix. Yeah. So it's symplectic, but yeah, it's holomorphic symplectic, from which I can make a family of holomorphic symplectic.
So that will be applicable to your first set if you have commutification also then.
No. So when I have, this setup arises when I have a nice quantizable compactification, then I can get this setup by picking only those divisors where my symplectic form has poles of order one. So, like in this Maxim story explained yesterday, he makes some blow-ups. So these are divisors. No, it's Lagrangian in the Cotangent bundle. It's Lagrangian in the conventional sense. The role of these divisors is that it restricts the behavior of L at infinity. The closure in the M log is compact. So that's what I. All right, so I have a collection of transversal disks. So, and again, when I look just at this individual smooth component, it's like in a Buzaid theorem. Yeah, so it's a cotangent bundle and a cotangent fiber. So then we can imagine that having the collection of this TI, we can define the algebra. And then the category which we are looking at, which I denote as local, stated with L, and H is fixed, means that H is a rescaling parameter. So it is defined as a category of finite dimensional DG modules, or A infinity modules, over some fixed algebra. And the definition of this algebra, it depends on this wrapped Foucault business. In particular, when I want to define, so this is a direct sum Ti to Tj. So I use some Hamiltonian flow to make this Ti and Tj intersect. So this is part of the framework of this wrapped Foucault business. So we need to ensure that there is a nice Hamiltonian floor. So and to explain it in detail, it really takes some time, which I do not have. So let me just assume, as if you'd like, as a black box, that this algebra can be defined. This is a notation for this algebra. And in the end, I have the category of finite dimensional, say, A infinity modules over this algebra. So in fact, this algebra this RL, it's negatively graded. Again, you can compare with this Abu-Zaid story. You see chains in degree, non-positive degree. And also, it lives over integer numbers. So in fact, what's going on, it's sort of generalization, if you'd like, of this Abu-Zaid result. Now, then, Having this in mind, I think that we can define, or at least we can expect that there is exists a key structure and this local Foucault category. For that, so I don't know whether we may assume it, but there exists, Z is not a field, but nevertheless, exists a minimal model for this algebra, and again, it's negatively graded, so we can take the zero degree component of the minimal model, which is an associative algebra. Degree zero component maybe it's easier. Yeah, but I need the notation. Yeah, you're right. Okay, so then I have a category of finite dimensional modules over this, which is an abelian category. All right. Now then, roughly speaking, the first approximation to the Riemann-Hilbert, because it will be a little bit more elaborate at what I am saying. It says that if I consider the category of holonomic DQ modules associated with the log extension, which has the fixed Lagrangian support, and when I consider its formally, then it is equivalent to the category of finite dimensional modules. Again, it's a rough formulation. Maybe it's better to say to the category of global sections of the local system of the categories of finite dimensional modules over this algebra. Over C star. Yeah. It's not a form, it will be more precise in a minute. So local system over C star. It just because, you know, it depends how much time will I have. So at least I can give a little bit imprecise formulation. So what is, at least what is clear that we have this algebra over Z, which is defined for every H. So then, in fact, it gives us a local system of categories over C star. So then we can take the category of global sections, but unfortunately, indeed, we cannot be sure that sections of this global category, that they can be, that they are meromorphic, that they have nice behavior at h equal to 0. So therefore, these are Laurent expansions of meromorphic functions. And here, it can be very wild. So then kind of more pedantically, what we should do, we should a little bit work on the right-hand side of the story. So for that, introduce a ring of formal power series. It just what I will be doing is to work out this right-hand side in order to give a precise formulation. So I consider the ring of series in complex powers of H and non-negative integer powers of a logarithm. Sum over everything over lambda and k. And this condition ensures that it's well defined. Lambda is in C and k is non-negative integer. So, you know, we need to take care about the monodromy. So that's the reason for introducing. So then it can be localized. It's the same definition, but with this condition is dropped. It's a localization of the one. Now, there is an automorphism of the bigger ring which preserves the smaller one. Okay. B to B. Which is defined in a clear way as a monodromy around lambda. So I denote it as psi. And there is also an automorphism of this algebra RL, which arises from the local system, arises from the monodromy. So arising, so this exists, this is a formula, and this arising the monodromy in H of this if you'd like of local system of this Foucault categories. So this automorphism descends, I will use just the same. It descends everywhere I want, in particular to the degree zero part of the cohomology ring. All right. Next, define sort of a combined subalgebra, which is an algebra of twisted Laurent polynomials in the additional variable T. So it's a Laurent polynomials and coefficients in this. So this is commutative, so everything is fine in this associative algebra. And the commutation relation of this new variable t this one. All right. So then we get an associative algebra, non-commutative associative algebra, and now consider the category. I denoted CL of modules over this algebra, which satisfies several conditions. So it is a free of finite rank over this commutative ring. So now it is generated by a B0 sublattice let's call it EZ preserved by the action of these additional variables. Okay, and so these modules, that's what we are going to use in this by the way, this category, just to make a remark, CL is a CH linear category. And in fact, it is abelian. So now the conjecture, so just a modification of this CL is equivalent this category, and this is an equivalence of abelian categories. All right. Now, it's a good question whether I should stop. Probably I should stop here. But what I plan to do, but I will do it next time, is an analytic version of this. So here there is no Stokes phenomenon. So what has been taken into account is just a monodromy of the family of Foucault categories with respect to this parameter h. Everything is formal, but next time I impose some additional assumptions on something, basically on the number of pseudo-holomorphic disks with a boundary on L for some exceptional directions of H, and we'll formulate a stronger conjecture over germs of meromorphic functions. And then we'll continue after that to more elaborate questions. So